I thank you all for being here with us. I will quickly like to call on a pastor, George Akigbe. He used to stand between the sticks in those days as goalkeeper for the school. But today, his role will be slightly different. He will not be holding the ball, he will be holding the mic as he gives us the opening prayer. Could we all please rise as we take the opening prayer? Please welcome him, Pastor George Akigbe.
Thank you. Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we just want to thank you for tonight. We want to thank you for the gathering of your people, for your word says that we are two or three are gathered together, that you are there present with them. We invite you, Holy Spirit, into all that we'll be doing today. And we ask, Lord, that you take absolute control in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says in Luke 1:37 that with our God that nothing shall be impossible. We have in mind to raise 500 million naira towards St. Finbar's endowment. And because you are the God with which all things are possible, we know that it has been. So we return all the honor, all the glory and adoration unto your holy name. All those that are yet to be with us, Father in heaven, we ask that you will bring to come join us soonest in the mighty name of Jesus. So that almost 70 years ago through Father Dennis Lang.
George Akigbe. I will ask that we remain standing because we will be taking the national anthem right now. I think we'll have the support of music in the background. Okay, the national anthem. Standing, I would like to ask some of the students of, but I'd like to explain that the school anthem is us while the rest of us hum along.
Thank you. Shall we go?
St. Finbar's College Akoka, my own source of knowledge. I'm proud to belong, I'm proud to belong to the citadel of excellence. Fidelitas,
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 fidelitas.
Up school.
Thank you. I actually think we did better in our days with what we imagined was a school song. We play. I'll tell you why. Of game.
Play your famous game for love of game.
Rob School! So that in those days, please, you may take your seats now. That in those days was what we imagined was the school. In those days, We were highly preoccupied with our soccer prowess. We were always going to the soccer field to damage the likes of St. Gregory's, King's College, Ibobi College, name them. So we had our war songs. We had our war songs, which we imagined were school songs. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to lay out the protocol for today. And this is so that it makes it easier for anyone who comes up the stage to make any speech to just do an abridged version. The chairman, board of trustees, QS Shegun Ajanlekoko, national president, St. Fimbres College Old Boys Association, Mr. Patrick Doyle, DC, His Grace, Archbishop of Lagos Diocese, Adewale Martins, here represented, Mr. Governor, the Governor of Lagos State, Babajide Sanwo-Olu, also here represented, His Excellency, the Irish Ambassador to Nigeria, Mr. Peter Ryan and his team, the School Administrator, St. Fimbres College, Akoka, Reverend Father Emmanuel Babalola, the guest speaker, Professor Reverend Father Anthony Akinwale, awardees, distinguished conquerors and benefactors, distinguished guests, members of the press, ladies and gentlemen. So from this point, you don't have to go through this entire protocol anymore. So all you need to say is, well, you could say you're standing on existing protocol, or simply identify His Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, and we move on. Thank you so much. I would also like to take the opportunity to acknowledge the presence of some of our very good friends who are here with us, some of them classmates, some of them ancestors, some of them old friends and old boys. We have with us Mr. Murphy Kieran. We have Albert Ijetimo, Francis Oguamanam, and Florence Oguamanam. Mr. Soji Alabi, who's a personal friend. Tunji Mayaki, sitting in the back of the hall somewhere there. Enebong Albert, Yejide Wise, and John Wise, my very good friend, Johnny. Ayonuka Adeleke, and a host of others. We will take those recognitions as we go along. I can see that the National President St. Fimbres College Old Boys Association is itching to... okay, so... excuse me for that breaking transmission. Usually I don't talk to people outside of stage. At this point, we have a documentary for you, and we'd like you to all sit back, relax, and enjoy this for the next few minutes. Thank you.
The Very Reverend Father Dennis Joseph Slattery was born in Fermoy, County Cork, Ireland on the 29th of February 1916. At 16 years of age in 1932, young Dennis began his missionary vocation and was ordained a priest of the Society of African Missions on the 17th of December 1939. By 1941, at the peak of the Second World War, the 25-year-old Irish priest embarked on a voyage to Africa, Nigeria, to be precise. On arrival on the shores of Nigeria, he was posted to Ilawe Ekiti, but was recalled to Lagos the following year and posted to St. Gregory's College as a teacher and games master. In 1943, he was again posted to the Catholic Printing Press, where he rose to be the editor of the Catholic Herald. As a journalist, he played a vagrant of the British colonial government, so much so that they unsuccessfully tried on three occasions to deport him. He was also a keen sportsman and played regularly for the Lagos United Football Club. At one time, he was chairman of the Nigerian Football Association, and he actually founded the Referees Association. Father Slattery's love and fervor for Nigeria most likely served as the impetus for his vision to found a secondary school with a dual curriculum of both grammar and technical education that would meet the needs of a soon-to-be independent Nigeria. The proposal for such an institution was presented to the Catholic Voluntary Agency in 1955. The result of that noble vision culminated in the founding of St. Finbarr's College on the 2nd of January 1956. The new institution, which was named after the patron saint of Father Slattery's beloved native County Cork in Ireland, was thus born with him as the founding principal.
The college started out with 68 students in borrowed classrooms
within the St. Paul's Catholic Primary School compound in Apapa Road, Ebutemeta, Lagos. Thereafter, the search for a permanent location finally led to the marshlands of Akoka, Yaba. So it was that barely 3 years after classes began on the premises of St. Paul's Primary School, Ebutemeta, St. Finbarr's College moved to its permanent site in 1959. 1 year after, the fledged institution sought and received the approval of the Federal Ministry of Education to enroll students for the West African School Certificate Examinations. Like all great institutions, the college has its fair share of epoch events in academics and sports, as well as stellar alumnus in diverse areas ranging from academia, sports, business, the professions, and the military, as well as media and entertainment. Truth be told, conquerors, as Finbarrians are referred to, are to be found in practically every field of human endeavor around Nigeria and globally.
Father Slattery was a colossus during our time. He was a field marshal, a general five-star who you cannot evade and who you cannot but see anytime you are in these premises. During our time, we were 90, we got whittled, and then we sat for the school cert in 69, and we had the best result in the whole of Lagos State with 31 grade ones. Father Slattery was inspiring. He was an embodiment of discipline, and there were four rules that guide the school during those days. Number one was, if you steal, you are out. If you cheat in exams, you are out. If you are caught loitering around the premises or outside the gate during school hours, you are out. And if you are caught smoking or taking drugs, you are out. So it was a highly disciplined college. And like I said, Father Slattery was the field marshal. I'm a quantum surveyor in practice, and I've been in practice for over 40 years. Whatever success story I can lay claim to is due to the fact that I have a solid foundation from this citadel of learning, St. Finbarr's College. And so it is heartwarming to come back to the ground and relive those old days.
My name is Kayode Bolarinwa Anibaba of St. Finbarr's 1970-74 set. I laid the foundation for my profession and what I am today was laid in that school. Of all the schools I attended, especially Father Dennis Joseph Slattery, whom I found to be a very prolific trainer of men. There was never a week for that.
Also, the impact St. Finbarr's College made on us academically, the combination of those two has made a lot of difference in our lives and in my life personally. And it's a pleasure to commemorate this day
on behalf of Father Slattery.
Hi, my name is Dr. Janae Logan. I'm a neurosurgeon here in Nashville, Tennessee, in the United States. I'm of the graduating class of 1996, and my first experience and exposure to real life, I believe, which has guided me through my arduous and yet rewarding path, started at St. Finbarr's College right there in Akoka. I am a member of the SF COBA group, and I'm a proud member at that. We're here to life and to my current state and where I am today. I'm truly grateful for that experience.
Hi, my name is Walter Ebweze, engineer here in the United States, class of 2008, St. Finbarr's College, Akoka, Lagos. St. Finbarr's was a very good college for me, like in terms of modeling my Nigerian culture, belief. Of course, in terms of sports, I was more in the athletics team, where I impacted the team in terms of success throughout my college year. And of course, most importantly, I won't go without mentioning late Father DJ Slattery, who was really, really impactful, his model, keeping his legacy and leaving his legacy across down to this year. So pretty much I won't be where I am without living that dream down across till my day now in the United States. So St. Finbarr's College was really, really the first foundation for me growing up.
Now you've been privileged to see the achievers, the products, and the caliber of the old boys of this great institution, St. Finbarr's College. All this is attributable to this founder, Reverend Father Dennis Joseph Slattery. Now, it is my singular honor and privilege as the chairman of the Board of Trustees of St. Finbarr's College Old Boys Association to welcome you most warmly to this epoch-making event of the annual Reverend Father Dennis Joseph Slattery Memorial Lecture and fundraising dinner for the St. Finbarr's College. Please give generously. In giving, manifold should be the return flow to you. I thank you all for coming.
We trust that we can count on you, our most distinguished guests, to rise to the occasion and be a part of a noble venture to sustain the legacy of a truly great Irish Nigerian, the Very Reverend Father Dennis Slattery. Thank you. Good evening and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. That said, in the years that I was in St. Finbar's College, I can proudly say there were only two Irish men in the school. One was on the staff as the principal. The other was there as a student, and a very diligently rascally student. Father Slattery and Patrick Doyle were both in St. Finbar's at about the same time. But so was Mr. Beckley. Okay. Mr. Beckley was a teacher who I had plenty run-ins with. He passed on recently, but before he passed on, he actually sent word and said he blesses me. I showed him a thing or two back in the day. But that said, ladies and gentlemen, I met the Irish ambassador recently, and his fervor for establishing the links between Ireland and Nigeria was contagious. For the first time, I felt proud of being a Nigerian of Irish descent, because this ambassador came gung-ho, and I'm feeling welcome within the Irish community in Nigeria as a result of his very, very rigorous diplomatic shuttling between Abuja and Lagos. Peter Ryan, the Irish ambassador, Your Excellency, we warmly, very warmly welcome you to this event. And I've always maintained to the ambassador that St. Finbar's College at Corker is the most significant, visible, and probably the proudest legacy of Irish clergymen in Nigeria. And we are proud to be associated with you, and we're so happy that you're here today. That said, ladies and gentlemen, the keynote address will be given by the Irish ambassador, His Excellency Peter Ryan, and now is the time for that address to be given. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Peter Ryan.
As we wait for Peter Ryan to come up here, I'd like us all to quickly recognize the presence of the chairman of today's event, Senator Anthony Adefuye. He is a distinguished senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the Baba Ijo of St. Dennis Church, Akoka. You're welcome, sir. Your Excellency, your time.
Thank you. Your Excellencies, Reverend Fathers, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to use my three favorite words in Nigeria, all protocol observed. How can you follow an actor who I saw being slapped on the face last night on Netflix? And I don't think we'll try and reenact that this evening, if that's okay. But look, I wanted to say what a great honor it is. It's a very humbling experience to be here as the representative of the government and the people of Ireland in a place that has brought such honor to the memory of one of our own. And I think Patrick said about the school being the living legacy, and I'm not going to disagree with him or anything like that. I'm going to say actually the legacy is all of you and all of the other people who are going around every day honoring the contribution that Father Slattery made. You might know that Father Slattery was born when Ireland was not independent, when Ireland also was a colony. He was born in 1916, in a very difficult year for Irish history, because it was the year when a very small number of people, about the number of people who are currently in this room, decided they were going to take on the largest empire in the whole world. And then they didn't tell each other about it, but they took it on nevertheless in Dublin in 1916, the year Father Slattery was born. in an extraordinary statement. They didn't plan on winning. They didn't think they'd win, and they certainly didn't win. But they left a legacy to the people who came behind them. And they said to the people who came behind them, we too deserve the right to secure our own futures and decide our own futures. So when Father Slattery was 5 years, the second largest city in Ireland, his city was burned to the ground by the colonial ruler. Not a small part of the city, the entire city was burned to the ground. And the people of Cork showed a little bit of resilience. They rebuilt their city, and within 1 year, they had secured the independence of their city. And Ireland secured its independence in 1922, when Father Slattery, and remember, his home place is a place called Donerail. I don't know whether anybody has been to Donerail yet, but Donerail is a little village outside of Cork. Very special place. A place where English was not the first language when Father Slattery was born. English was the second language. So there's no surprise that when Father Slattery came to Nigeria in 1939, the first thing he did was learn a local language, because he came from a place where English wasn't the first language. So it was very natural for him. I've got to speak the language of the boys I'm going to be seeing every day. But as our chairman will know very well, Father Slattery came from an extraordinarily rich heritage of education and culture, because St. Finbar, after whom your illustrious school is named, had built a school in Ireland, in Cork, 1,500 years before. And what did he do? Schools were built in Cork of both Christian faiths. They were both named after him. They were both named St. Finbar. Such was the esteem in which he was held. And what was the greatest fear for our colonial masters? The greatest fear was education, education, and more education. So I'm not surprised at all when I read, and I read the wonderful stories, and to hear and to watch the wonderful stories of the contribution of Father Slattery here, that his commitment to education and to ethical upbringing and moral upbringing, and sports too, because we have to be fit and healthy, we have to be competitive, and to be the best we can be to achieve our potential. Now, Father Slattery's hometown in Cork is pretty famous for its sports stars also. Many of you will watch the Premier League and you'll see Roy Keane on television. Yeah, Roy Keane. He doesn't lie down, he's not quiet. I'm sure the Nigerian Referees Association won't be inviting him to their annual dinner. But he exemplifies. So when I hear of the stories of Father Slattery supporting those people at their time of need and putting himself in the face of danger. Homework about Father Slattery. The largest retirement home for SMA fathers, surprise, surprise, is in Cork. Okay? Not very far from where Father Slattery is from. I spoke to them on Saturday, 2 days ago, and I said to them, is there anybody there who remembers Father Slattery? And they said, Peter, whether they remember him or not, they'll tell you stories about him. And some of the stories will be true. And I like that. So he's caught on as a bit of a legend and as a bit of a character also. There's 40 retired SMA fathers living in that house in Blackrock Road in County Cork. 35 of them lived and worked in Nigeria. Now, I don't know about you, but that's a pretty special contribution to have made from a little tiny island, 1/15th the size of Nigeria. Our people came here. Our people came here to educate and to contribute to the development of this country. We're grateful for it, and it's very warming to see that you guys appreciate that and haven't forgotten your founder and haven't forgotten the contribution they made to this great country. I should say also that I promised to bring back a suitcase full of some Nigerian food for the fathers when I go home. So the two words I like the most when I'm traveling, two words, you might know them, you might have heard them already. It's called diplomatic immunity. So usually I can bring whatever I like in the bag once it's edible. And that's my plan, is to go back to visit them. And you'll know also that when Father Slattery was reaching out to set a standard in St. Finbar's, to set a standard for this country, when this country would achieve its independence, that it would need leaders, that it would need people who were going to step up and serve in their community and have a commitment to public service. You'll know that he, of course, borrowed from his own history in Ireland. So the school that he went to in Ireland is a school that provided many of the great leaders in our country. And there's a very funny story about probably our greatest leader from Cork City, also immortalized in Hollywood, not yet in Nollywood, but maybe Patrick can help us. So there was a man called Michael Collins, who was a leader against the British in the struggle for Irish independence. And Michael Collins, funnily enough, he would have made a good goalkeeper, like the guy who was up earlier, like Patrick. Michael Collins is a big guy, so they called him the big fella, the big fella. And on the day that the British army were marching out of Dublin for the last time, the commander of the British army was a man called General MacCready. MacCready had arranged that the Irish army would march in at 12 noon and that the British army would march out at 12 noon. 12 noon passes, 12:01 passes. Army in their new green uniforms at 12:08, 8 minutes late. And the general looks at his watch and he says, "General Collins, you're 8 minutes late." To which Collins replies, "We've waited 800 years for our independence. You can wait 8 minutes." And it's an interesting reminder to us about the big swathes of history we're dealing with. Ordinary. We're very fortunate that one of our people was on that journey with you. We hope that we can be on the next phase of the journey with you also. You'll also know that the Irish and Nigerians share lots of similar traits and interests. One of the things that we do is we never go to a party on our own. The Nigerians never arrive on their own to a party. The Irish are the same. So today I didn't come on my own either, on an effort to might stand up there and you can, so you'll recognize her when you're going to have a chat with her. I want to thank Kieran Murphy for taking the time to join us. Kieran, if you don't mind, please. I want to thank Miss Aduke Gomez, who of course is from right here, and many of you will know her very well. And my great friend, I want to move the embassy to Lagos, but I have to wait for the government to call the real capital. So it's another similarity between Cork and Lagos. Links with one another, our education links, and also in the sports area, and music, and dance, and maybe a movie or two as well. So we want to be on that journey with you at the next phase of St. Finbar's. And we'll do whatever we can to support and facilitate that. And if you're thinking that Ireland has changed since Father Dennis left and Nigeria has changed, there's never been a better time, in my opinion, to improve the connections between Father Dennis's home place and this flowering, if you like, of the Nigerian community in Ireland. We're seeing, you won't be surprised to know that last week when our soccer team played, we had 5 Irish players of Nigerian heritage. I think the next time we might need 11 for the evening. Please drop over and say hello to St. Finbar's to be at the heart of that. I'm going to finish now with just one very short story. And they're all true, Reverend Anthony, just like I'm looking forward to your lecture as well. But Cork is famous for something else. In 1912, a very famous ship that some of you might have heard of that was built in Ireland had its last stop just next door to Cork in a place called Cove, which is right next to Cork City. And that ship, which some of you might have heard of, apparently there's a movie about it. It's called the Titanic. Yeah? You heard of the Titanic? Everyone heard of the Titanic? So the Titanic's last stop for passengers, so it's built in Belfast in Ireland, it sails to Southampton, picks up a few passengers and stops in a place called Cove, C-O-B-H. And it stops in Cove, and that's its last stop before the fatal night, the terrible night when so many lives were lost and everything else came in history. And they asked somebody in Cork, the New York Times, or one of the New York papers anyway, had went to Europe and were interviewing people in Cork, and they said, you know, the last place on the fateful voyage that the Titanic stopped was right here in Cove. What do you have to say about that? And they asked this guy on the street in Cork, and Patrick, do you know what his reply was? It was okay when it left here. Ladies and gentlemen, Gurv Míle Maígh, I wish you well. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Just a second, Your Excellency. Just a second. And really, and I don't care if they get jealous, but at times like this, I always take my moment of fame. I'm going to get a handshake from you, and we're going to get the photographers to come around. This is the only time I have today to make it to the Ovation magazine. Where are the photographers? Another round of applause for His Excellency, the Irish Ambassador to Nigeria, Peter Ryan. Thank you, sir. And indeed, he nailed it. You know, there were a lot of things he said that were really, really profound. He unmasked our founder and father. He told us a few more things that make us understand why he was who he was. Right? Now I see why whenever he got angry, his hair will stand rebelliously at the top of his forehead. And for those of us who met him in school, you know, Father Slattery was an amazing man. You know, I remember days when we had soccer matches and he would declare that we would only have like half the time in school. School was shut down at 1 o'clock. But the first period, you know, was always spent learning the songs that we will sing when we go out to play. Owegbe lugbe o. Owegbe lugbe o. Owegbe lugbe o. Owegbe lugbe o. Ade ori o. Owegbe lugbe o. Bata ese wa o. Owegbe lugbe o. And that's deliberate. That song I did just now is deliberate. I remember in 1970, we met Baptist Academy. Remember? We walloped them. How many? 4-2. And so we decided that we'll rub it in their faces. And today, we've managed to bring shamelessly to our event the president of the Baptist Academy Old Boys Association. He's sitting here with his tail between his legs. I'd like you all to give a warm welcome to Mr. Aki Fatunke, who joined us. I would have loved to be a Fimbarian. But we welcome you as a brother. We welcome you as a brother. Thank you so much, Aki. Thanks so much. So we will move on now. I think we have some serious talk. We have a lecture, and it will be given by our guest speaker. He is Professor Reverend Father Anthony Akinwale. Could we all please welcome him as he comes up the stage to give us a talk on retrieving and protecting our common humanity. He's an old boy. He's an old boy. So I want to hear that round of applause. He's an old boy of that college. And today, as he steps up the stage proudly, He is an example of who you can be as a Fimbarian. I'm not sure I can be a Reverend Father anyway, but you're welcome, sir.
Well, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I don't want to stretch the protocol, but permit me to recognize someone so dear to me in this gathering, my maternal uncle, Pa George Okufi, is here with us. I think he stepped out briefly. Some of our past students of St. Fimbers were his students while he was rector at Yaba College of Tech between 1975 and 1985. A man who has had a lot of influence on me. He happens to be a Gregorian, so I have to be very careful what I say about St. Gregory's here. But I'll tell you. It is for me a privilege, a rare one for that matter, to have been chosen by the Old Boys Association of our alma mater, St. Fimbers College, as recipient of the Distinguished Conqueror Award, and the year 2023 speaker at the Father Dennis Slattery Memorial Lecture. Father Slattery was a close friend to my parents. Indeed, he was one of the priests present when my parents got married. And he was one of the priests who inspired me to want to become a priest. A lot has been said about his contributions to education and sports in Nigeria. I don't think I need to go into that. But they are visible in the many outstanding personalities whose potential he actualized by his selfless dedication to his priestly duties, to education and to sports. Today we have the legitimate pride of being products of a school that has produced academics, footballers, and among those footballers, we have produced five captains of the national soccer team and two coaches of the national soccer team. I once had an exchange with late Governor Lam Adesina of Oyo State. He passed through Loyola College in Ibadan. And when I told him at a public gathering that St. Fimbers College taught Loyola College some lessons in football, he retorted and asked, "Has your school produced any governor?" Well, at the end of the event, I asked a question: who puts more smiles on the faces of Nigerians? Governors or footballers? Tonight, in honor of Father Slattery, and as a token of gratitude to St. Fimbers College Old Boys Association for honoring us, I have chosen to speak on the topic, retrieving and protecting our common humanity. It is my modest attempt to remember a man who not only influenced me to attend the school he founded, but also, perhaps without knowing it, inspired me to want to be a priest involved in education and gave me a letter of recommendation when I told him I wanted to be a Dominican friar. As at Friday, September 22, 2023, it was estimated by the world population clock that our planet was populated by 8.6 billion inhabitants. Nigeria, with a population estimated at 225 million, counts as the sixth most populous country in the world, the most populous on the African continent, indeed the largest concentration of blacks in the world. The world is a race of many races, but many are the adversities on that the distinction and multitude of things come from the intention of the first agent, the Creator. For he brought it represented by one creature alone, he produced many and diverse creatures, that what was wanting to one in the representation of the divine goodness might be supplied by another. For goodness, which in God is simple and uniform, in creatures is manifold and divided. And hence, the whole universe together participates in the divine goodness more perfectly and represents it better than any single creature whatever. End of quote. The distinction of creatures is not just a distinction of genre. It is also a distinction within genre. And that is where racial distinction comes into the discussion. The human race is a race of races. The distinction is willed by God. Africans are not together. Within the same, and African scholars find it convenient to maintain a deafening deconstructive presupposition can be found in Chinua Achebe's Things Fall Apart and in the lyrics of one of my favorite musicians, the lyrics of his song, Why Black Man They Suffer, in which he said, we dey sit down for our land, Jeje. We dey mind our business, Jeje. Some people come from faraway land. Them fight us and take our land. Them take our people and spoil our towns. Now since then, trouble start. Our riches then take away to their land. In return, then give us their colony. Them take our culture away from us. Then give us them culture we no understand. Black people, we no know ourselves. We no know our ancestral heritage. We dey fight each other every day. We're never together. Capacity to dominate is found in every human being, colonialists. This propensity can only be moderated, conversion to what is true, to what is good, and to what is loving. Xenophobia comes from fear and suspicion of the foreigner. History shows that before Africa's contact with European colonialists, we Africans were fighting on tribal lines, and that even within the same ethnic community, all was not well. There is only a semblance of solidarity when there is a perceived common enemy. Where was African communalism when the Tutsi and the Hutu were massacring each other in Rwanda? Where was African sense of common life during the ethnic cleansing military coups of January 15 and July 29, 1966 in Nigeria? Where was Ujamaa, the philosophy of Julius Nyerere, when the Igbo were being killed before and during the Nigerian Civil War? Where was Ajobi and Ajogbe during the Ife and Modakeke altercation? As we speak, there is heightened insecurity in Nigeria, and accusing fingers are being pointed across boundaries of ethnic communities. I must at this point differentiate between ethnicity and ethnocentrism. Ethnicity is a legitimate love of one's ethnic community. It is different from ethnocentrism, which is use of one's ethnic affiliation for purposes of malicious solidarity against members of another ethnic community. In other words, the former is a virtue, the latter is a vice. Xenophobia is the offspring of ethnocentrism. It is not peculiar to Africa. Europeans fought their own interethnic wars before they opted for liberal democracies. To reduce ethnic and religious tension, they put in place constitutions that protect the citizen from the hands of government. But in Africa, what has been tamed by constitutional provisions elsewhere has been institutionalized in Africa, even built into our constitutions. Even organs and functionaries of state are used to propagate it. Around Dakar, Senegal. That war was a most tragic instance of failure to recognize our common humanity. But Slattery was a man to the task Father Slattery set out to accomplish, a task he has left us to accomplish, a task he has left us to accomplish, and that task is the task of retrieving, protecting, and promoting our common humanity. Just a decade after he founded St. Finbar's College, Nigeria experienced military coup d'etat. This took place during that first coup in Nigeria on January 15, 1966. The killing of Eastern Nigerians living in Northern Nigeria on May 30, 1966. Further ethnic cleansing on the day of the second military coup on July 29, 1966, and during the Nigeria-Biafra War, 1967 to 1970, our common humanity. But the immediate and remote fact faces at amalgamation in cities around the Niger. The Nigeria engendered by the British had no constitution for its first 8 years. From the Clifford Constitution of 1922, the very first, to the 1979 Constitution and its identical twin, the 1999 Constitution, a validating instance of Plato's philosophy of history, according to which every regime is worse than its immediately preceding regime. Here we are in a country whose constitution is dangerously deficient, whose weak institutions have repeatedly demonstrated a lack of capacity to proship. Nigerians have lost their sovereignty to a political class whose interests does not coincide with the interest of the population. Father Slattery founded a school that attracted students from various ethnic communities in Nigeria. My generation of old boys of St. Fimbas entered the school 4 years after the Nigeria-Biafra War and concluded our secondary education in 1979, the year Nigeria experienced the end of the first bout of pestilential military rule. We studied, we played, and evolved together without casting aspersions at our various ethnic communities. Almost 4.5 decades after we left St. Fimbas, we find ourselves in a country that has betrayed the noble aspiration that made Father Slattery establish an alma mater for us, an alma mater we are justifiably proud of. The aspiration to build a nation, not a state held together at gunpoint. Today, the common humanity and common citizenship of the Nigerian are abbreviated once the Nigerian crosses the boundary of his local government area. In a supposedly democratic polity, the right of the Nigerian to cast a vote in an election is either abbreviated or altogether denied by force or by an electoral process whose deficiencies we lack the political and moral will to remedy. Father Slattery saw from afar that good education serves as antidote to this unhappy state of affairs, not just by producing technocrats, but by producing technocrats with ethical competence. Our alma mater must continue to intensify its efforts to provide education that forms Nigerians who will participate in the task of building a new civilization of love in which our common humanity and its dignity are retrieved, protected, and promoted. And the event at which we gather tonight brings us together with our friends and well-wishers to assist the school to provide this type of education by generously providing the means necessary for the attainment of this goal. In a polity of magnificent complexity such as Nigeria, multi-ethnic, multi-religious, and multi-ideological in character, obstinate refusal and persistent failure to cultivate a veritably democratic culture has manufactured in abundant but disturbing quantity a ready recipe for instability, a formidable obstacle on the path of development. The instability engendered has itself given birth to a land richly endowed by the Maker, but inhabited by the most impoverished human beings on the planet. That is what it means to say Nigeria is the poverty capital of the world. But Nigeria has no business with poverty. Education changes its narrative when it inculcates the virtue of respect for our common humanity, inclusive and equal citizenship. With this, we can attain the national integration that is requisite for authentic development. And development, said Pope Paul VI, is another name for peace. For the sake of our children and our children's children, we must build a nation where the rights of a citizen will not be abbreviated and violated because of religious or ethnic affiliation. Let us live above the divisive rhetoric of our political elite. Let us live up to the words of our old national anthem. Though tribe and tongue may differ, in brotherhood we stand. But if we are unwilling to undertake this noble venture of transmutation of our country from a state held together at gunpoint to a veritable association of peoples who share core values, which is what a nation is, let us have the wisdom and the courage to peacefully dissolve the amalgam of Frederick Lugard. Never again shall we shed blood. On a practical note, each of us on social media must refrain from posting hate speech, insulting and demonizing people because of the language they speak, because of how they worship God, or because of how they voted, or how they will vote. And if you know of anyone who uses hate speech, caution that person. Tell him or her, no to xenophobia, no to ethnic cleansing, no to bloodshed. As members of diverse ethnic, religious, and regional communities, rather than trade insults, let us exchange ideas. I reiterate my gratitude to the St. Finbar's College Association for choosing me to deliver this lecture, and I thank you for listening.
Thank you. Prof. May I ask for my moment of fame? And you would want to know who wrote that script. I did. Thank you very much, sir. May we have another round of applause for him. Thank you. He couldn't have been better put. He touched on all the points, all the points. Wow. We have to move a little quickly now on our feet. We've gotten to the point where we have to get to the crux of the matter, which is the launching of the endowment fund. But we are not going to do that until we've heard from a gentleman whom I introduced earlier as a distinguished senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and also the Babajo of St. Denis' Church. That's not all. I'm told that he also chaired the 80th birthday party of our founder, very Reverend Father Dennis Joseph Slattery in those days. I'd like you all to welcome for a few minutes the chairman of today's occasion, Senator Anthony Adefuye. Please put your hands together for him. Please don't stop. Don't stop. He's not here yet. We'd like to hear a word or two from him. We are told that this gentleman happened to be one of the closest to Reverend Father Dennis Slattery. And so I think the round of applause should start now. Would you want me to have my moment of fame before or after? As I like it. So I'll take it now. My moment of fame. Thank you. Over to you, sir.
Good evening, everybody. I'm sorry I came late. The traffic was bad. I actually left home very early, but I got here late. I met Father Slattery by accident. I was living in Akoka, and I was attending the church, St. Dominic's Catholic Church. I think you know where it is. You know where Akoka is. You know where St. Dominic's is. And this day, as usual, I was running late to attend the service at St. Dominic's. And I had the credo being sung from St. Finbar's. And I suspected there must be a church there. So I stopped and entered. And honestly, there was a church, and Father Slattery was the priest. So I attended the service. And it was during the harvest time. And they were asking for donation for harvest. And after about 1 minute, nobody volunteered to, to say they want to donate anything. So I stood up. I was just a 1 year graduate at that time. I think that was 1972. And I said, 10,000 naira. I give 10,000 naira. 10,000 naira at that time is like saying 1 million. And there was they were looking. Who is that? And then Father Slattery came and then said I should come forward and say it again. I said, 10,000 naira. I donated 10,000 for the harvest. I had 48,000 in my pocket. I was going to pay for my annual house rent. So I took the 10,000 naira and paid. And everybody clapped again when I came out from the church. Voila. No, I'm not saying this so that you can donate to here today heavily, but if you do, God will bless you. I recovered. I thought I was not going to be able to pay. I was really harassed by the landlord, for 1 week or the other. But that month, a lot of things happened which I cannot explain. I paid my 48 pounds. I think you call it pounds at that time, or naira, I don't know. But it was almost the same. I was able to pay. God blesses a very good donor. So that was how we met. Now the second time, this time, I have enjoyed my donation to the church, my 10,000 naira donation to the church. I was rich. I'm telling you, at that time, I have become very rich. So a particular political party came to meet me to stand for Senate. And I said, no, there's no way I'm going to come and waste my money, and so on and so forth. After long pressure, and I said, okay, let me contact my priest. If he says yes, I will stand. If he says no, I will stand. So I went to Father Slattery, and I said, this is what this political party told me. They want me to stand for Senate. He said, what did you tell them? I said, well, I want to consult my priest first. He said, is that so? He said, okay, I will pray for it. I will pray, and I will let you know. So one Sunday, I was in the service, and briefly, he just stopped after his sermon and said, he came to me really. He didn't even announce my name, pulled my hand, brought me to the altar, and said, this is our next senator. And here I am. I became a senator. Honestly. I had put my mind off. I became a senator. So from then on, we became friends. And nothing, anything. In fact, I remember one time I was having a lot of trouble with my wife, and I went to him and I said, I don't understand what is happening. And he said, you two, come home early. Don't leave your wife. Come home early. Close early and let your wife feel you. Now, I agreed, but I was coming home early, and then I didn't find my wife at home. So one day I asked the house girl, I said, where is mommy? I said, he's going to church. Church? Do you know the church? He said, yes. And then I followed her to the church. And it was a Pentecostal church. Me, Baba Ijo. My wife in Pentecostal church. So I waited and allowed them to finish. When they finished, my wife came out. I grabbed the hand, went to the pastor, yes, they call them pastor, and said, look, if you allow my wife to come here again, I will beat you up. I'm not joking. If you let her enter here again, I will beat you up because I know you are fake. And you are fake. So, after a while, maybe 4 weeks later or so, I came home again, and she wasn't there. So I went to that church. She was there. I scattered everything, you know. I caused a lot of trouble. They didn't allow them to finish. When she came home, I said, madam, this marriage is finished. Me, Baba Ijo, you going to all this church, it's not possible. So she went and reported me to Father Slattery that I told her to leave. And Father Slattery said, what did you do? He said, because I went to Pentecostal church. He said, he came there and he almost beat up the pastor. And so on and so forth. He said, no, Tony cannot do that. He said he did it. He said, okay, you can go. I will see Tony later. So when he saw me, he said, your wife came to report you. I said, what did he say? He said, I should tell him what happened. I said, no, tell me what he said. And he repeated all he said. And I said, yes, I did. Really? I said, yes, I did. So what happened? I said, look, I cannot be Baba Ijo and my wife will be Pentecostal. That is fake. I cannot accept that. She has to go or she has to come to Catholic Church. So he called my wife later and said, I have spoken to your husband. He insisted he will divorce you if you continue to go to Pentecostal church. But I can help you. He said, yes. I will give you 3 months, you know, for you to, I will give you lecture and make you, and baptize you in 3 months. And after 3 months, I will marry the both of you together. If you agree, I will tell Tony. What do you call it again? Huh? Yeah, catechism. Thank you. And in 3 months, she was baptized in the Catholic Church, and we were married again. And I can tell you, we never had any problem again. You are Catholics. You don't know what you gain. You don't know what you are. You don't know. Some of you don't know. I know. And I'm telling you, when you are in the Catholic Church, you are an agent of God. You are blessed. I'll tell you today, you are blessed. There are so many things that has happened. In fact, now, I will be 80 next year. I hardly go to church, but I attend the church online. 350, Lumen Christi. Is that it? Lumen Christi. Every Sunday, if I cannot go, I will turn to my Lumen Christi and attend service. I'm proud to be a Catholic. Are you proud to be one? Now, I went to Cork to see Father Slattery, and he told me he wants to be buried.
Tonight, we must fulfill Father Slattery's dream, having a premier institution that epitomizes what an ideal educational institution, secondary education, should be. In my routine, daily routine, I start the day with prayer, and then I think I go into WhatsApp maybe 3 hours later, because once you go into WhatsApp, you can't get out. And sometimes I have over 1,000 messages on my WhatsApp. But this morning, as soon as I entered into my WhatsApp, I saw something that will depict, that spoke about what we plan to do today. Before that video will be relayed, but I want to know here among us, is there anyone that is 30 years old or less than 40 among us here? Apart from the students, so old boys. Okay, so this video is very instructive. Please, Mr. President, can they show us this video? It's just for a few minutes before we go to the luncheon.
Have you ever thought about this? In 100 years, so like in 2123, we will all be buried with our relatives. Strangers will live in our homes we fought so hard to build, and they will own everything we have today. Have you ever thought about this? In 100 years, so like in 2123, we will all be buried with our relatives and friends. Strangers will live in our homes we fought so hard to build, and they will own everything we have today. All our possessions will be unknown and unborn, including the car we spent a fortune on, and will probably be scrap, preferably in the hands of an unknown collector. Our descendants will hardly know who we are, nor will they remember us. How many of us know who our grandfather's father was? After we die, we will be remembered for a few more years, and then we are just a portrait on someone's bookshelf. And a few years later, our history, photos, and deeds disappear into history's oblivion. We won't even be memories. If we paused one day to analyze these questions, perhaps we would understand how ignorant and weak the dream to achieve it all was. If we could only think about this, surely our approaches, our thoughts would change, and we would be different people. Always having more, no time for what's really valuable in this life. I'd change all of this to live and enjoy the walks I've never taken, these hugs I didn't give, these kisses for our children and our loved ones, these jokes we didn't have time for. Those would certainly be the most beautiful moments to remember. After all, they would fill our lives with joy. And we waste it day after day with greed, and intolerance. What a shame.
What that little video encapsulates is that none of us is going to take anything back when we leave here. Whatever it is we have, whatever it is we run to possess, at the last time of our earthly existence, they will be shared by others, or they will be lost into oblivion. What legacy do you and I want to leave behind? We are talking of Father Slattery today because of his good legacies. He came all the way from Ireland at the age of 26, not to Lagos, to Inyekiti. I was telling His Excellency, I said, even now, Father Slattery came in 1931 or something. He laid down his life for us to have good education. He was the singular person who made sure that the mission schools were returned to the missionaries. I was with him throughout the journey, and we used to go to Alausa Secretariat, and he would go and confront Otedola. Otedola, you must let these Catholics or the missionaries, he didn't speak of Catholic schools alone, all the mission schools, that they must be returned back, that they need to experience what the school is like. And it was pathetic when the states, the government took over the school. In fact, at a point, St. Finbar's was turned into a co-educational institution. There was no window, no toilet, and the teachers were unruly because they said they didn't own their existence to old boys or to the Catholic, that they were employed by Lagos state government. It was such a pathetic situation, and he fought hard. In the end, we got the schools back, and coincidentally, as soon as this current president got into office as governor, he gave back all the missionary schools in Lagos to the missionaries. And that was the beginning of the new upbuilding for St. Finbar's College. The old boys have tried, the Catholic have tried, the Archbishop and so on, but we can't stop the momentum. The school needs all the resources and the support that we all can give, and that's the kernel of today's gathering. Dip your hands into your pockets and let us show gratitude for the opportunity of going to this citadel of learning. And so the race has begun. We were to eat before this, but they say if we eat, people will go. So that's why we changed the narrative. We say, let us all come and show who we are and how we believe in education. Father Slattery, his book, we have to immortalize as we immortalize his name. In the last chapter of his book, he said he knows Nigerians, he trusts Nigerians. He said, whatever they do, they don't play with education, because education is light. And we all do it. We will spend our last dime to ensure that we give quality education to our children. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is my singular honor to call on the president of the FC to, I don't know how to do the Rotarian, and I know Senaya is a Rotarian. The MC, pass the baton over to you to kickstart this special item on the program.
Yes, sir.
So that Finbar's can turn into a university in no too distant a future. Thank you, distinguished ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you very much, Chairman BOT. So how do we do this? I think I need help here. If I knew how to raise money, I wouldn't be where I am today. But we will try. We will try. And I think the best way to do this is that we all are here for a purpose. We know that apart from having dinner.
Actually, John and I, we started our broadcast careers on the same day.
Yes, we did
in
the same
in 1980.
That's right.
At the Federal Radio Corporation of Nigeria. Nigeria.
Okay, you only say you can't hear Oyibo past me.
I had an unfair advantage. It was biological.
But must be said, the Irish blood in you came out.
Yes. let me say it straight away that gentlemen, especially our guests,
yes,
we are not in the habit of just asking people to come to our aid in terms of making donations. As we speak, a lot of our distinguished old boys have collectively put together the sum of 60 million naira towards the...
Whoa.
I know them, and I'm looking at them in the face, and we're very grateful to them. It is only after we have done this that we feel the need to look outside of St. Finbar's for support.
Yeah.
And in that direction, we have invited some of our very special guests. I would like to ask the some of our esteemed awardees to this evening, shortly after this, some of our more distinguished old boys will formally receive the title called Distinguished Conqueror. And that it will be conferred on them this evening. So I would like at this time, because they were told to invite their friends to come and identify with them. So I say hallelujah.
Okay, so we're back here. Yeah.
Okay, now thank you. We're back on. So one of our old boys who promised to bring his friends here. I don't know. I'm looking at you. We're looking at each other. So who has brought his friend here who is going to, as it were, show some solidarity? Are you present? Where is that friend here?
Yes, he is.
That friend is here.
You could name him. If you want to.
Our senior advocate. Senior advocate, is your friend here?
Ah, okay.
David, is your friend here? Please, come and introduce your friend and let him... Oh, he's anonymous too.
He's anonymous.
Okay, he's going to do something.
Okay.
Okay, so please...
Please, let's give him a round of applause and...
Okay, so who... Is there anyone here who doesn't want to be anonymous? Otherwise, we will pass the pledge slips around.
And if by chance we have anyone here who has his rent in his pocket, just like the chairman, could you please declare your rent? And you know what happened to the chairman when he declared his 10,000 naira rent? It came back to him
manifold. He became a senator.
Any
aspiring senators here? But we understand the signs of the times, and we know that coming out and making huge donations publicly is probably a no-no at this point. So,
yes.
The chairman of the finance committee, Mr. Funmi Ademosu, has arranged for pledge slips to be passed around. And by perchance, if you have a check and you'd like to make good on it, feel free to do so.
Okay. So I think what we should do is let us ask our chairman, sir, do you have your rent in your pocket today?
He's a landlord. He doesn't pay rent.
Would you like to kick off this?
The microphone, yes. Fine.
Let's know how much of your rent you'll be willing to let go of this evening. Our chairman, Senator Defuye, we trust that if you want us to bring Father Slattery back...
1 million.
1 million naira! 1 million! Please give him a round of applause. Give him a round of applause. And it's infectious. It's infectious. I know that around that table, I smell a lot of millions. So should we go around that table It catches fast.
The senior advocate of Nigeria wants to say a word.
He said we didn't have it. It was dollar, euro, or pound.
He didn't say naira, it was dollar.
Naira. Okay.
He said he didn't have it. It was dollar, euro, or pounds.
No, we assumed it's pounds. We just assumed it's pounds. So.
When I send it, you know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So we will move quickly. May I have one of the pretty ladies with me? I don't work without them. Do we by any chance on this table have any more donations to support the chairman? He's a Liverpool fan. He never walks alone. So we know that... Okay. Would like to pledge one thing or the other. Thank you very much. We'll wait for the ambassador. Oh, thank you. Hello. Hi. Okay. Our former attorney general. Hello, sir. I always want my moment of fame. Where are the camera? Thank you. Etimoshe. Yes. You know, I've been trying to track this man down for ages. I never knew it would be easy. So, sir, could you just make a declaration for us?
Well, you know, I'm now unemployed. So that obviously affects what I can do. But, you know, as a Fimbarian, I've always supported the school. I'll continue to support the school to announce it. There's EFCC, ICPC. Those ones are even good. Then there are
any plans? No, nothing from Baptist Academy, old boys. I know why. They've been belly aching since 1972. Belly aching. 4-2. We gave them 4-2, 4-2 at, I think you had, what's his name? Yebufra, one of those. he wants to fight back. You can't fight back 50 years after, sir.
As much as I don't want to take retaliation, John, you brought me in here and you said I have my tail.
Between your legs.
Meanwhile, the chairman of the occasion has said that so many years they had to dip a tie in somebody's.
So
haven't said that.
I should remove my tie.
Haven't said that.
Otherwise,
I think that routing that you're referring to was in 1972.
1972, yes. It was 4-2. I was there at the stadium.
No. It was a 2-goal difference, no doubt. But it was 2-0. Yes, and I mean, with all due respect and regards,
yes.
And I have my dear sister here.
Yes.
Yeah, my dear sister here, Major General Amosu retired. Mm. I am sure we of the Alliance Schools in Lagos, comprising St. Finbarr's ourselves, Methodist Girls High School, just name them, the Bombers, St. Gregory's.
You beat other schools.
St. Gregory's.
No, St. Gregory's. Oh, St. Gregory's.
Your seniors, reckoned, we beat them.
No record. Nobody reckoned with St. Gregory's. Those years.
Not true.
Thank you very much, sir.
All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, the microphone right now finds His Excellency, the Ambassador of Ireland in Nigeria, Peter
Ryan.
Thank you very much. I thought you might have heard enough of me earlier on. I think the public servants in the room will recognize that we are always very enthusiastic to assist and help, but the decision, of course, has to come from our leadership. But I think one of the reasons why we came here today and why we appreciate the connection with St. Finbar's is to see what we can do to help continue this relationship into the future. And delighted to assure you, as I did earlier this year, that we'll continue that effort. So thanks to everybody who has supported. We'll continue to try and find ways to cement that relationship. I think that it's an opportunity, I think, for example, for a scholarship between St. Finbar's to go, for somebody to go to Ireland. And perhaps in the sporting way, maybe we need to get some more Irish over here to visit St. Finbar's also. So if there's some connection that we can make with that. Kieran, the man, you have some good people around. We have some good people in our community here. And I think on behalf of the embassy's part, what I didn't tell you, Patrick, and you'll remember this, but I haven't told the wider group, okay, that we're in the process of building our largest ever embassy on the continent of Africa. It's currently being built in Abuja.
Wow.
I look forward to welcoming St. Finbar's there, perhaps as our guests, as soon as we do open.
Yes.
And it'll be another little bit of Ireland in Nigeria, and we look forward to welcoming you.
I'm Irish too.
Everyone wants to be Irish. It's great. We're very lucky. But we look forward to welcoming you there. And,
thank you so much.
You have to wear the yellow and blue.
Thank you. Thank you, Your Excellency.
Thank you very much.
His Excellency Peter Ryan. I think at this point, maybe we should change our approach. We have forms. We have forms. Want any announcements? If you want to make any instant announcement, you're allowed to do so, just like the gentleman here. Thank you, sir. Could you please identify yourself? I look like, were you in my class?
Now you're senior.
I think I'm your senior.
Now you're okay. Senior.
So he's one of those we refer to as our ancestors.
Thank you so very much. Very glad to be here. Oloye Adegbega Adeniji is my name. And I'm a politician. A politician with a difference. When you say politician in Nigeria, you know, I'm a practical politician.
Wow, that's a new one.
We believe in service to humanity.
Okay.
So I'm going to take a cue from the chairman's speech to make a pledge.
Not your rent?
Not my rent.
Okay.
But from an incoming president of Nigeria, so okay, that as it happened to him, as became a senator,
yes,
that fellow too will become the president of Nigeria. So on behalf of, he will be anonymous, I won't mention his name.
Okay.
That's right. Pledging 1 million naira.
Wow.
Yes, thank you very much.
Wow.
On behalf of an incoming president of Nigeria, 2027.
Wow.
Thank you very much.
Wow. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. I, at this point, to quickly, like to acknowledge the presence of the chairman, North American chapter, St. Finbar's College Old Boys Association. Could we all please put our hands together? He's coming all the way from the U.S. to be with us today. Let's put our hands together as we welcome Otumba, former chairman, Otumba Awofeso. And he's been here with us.
He is one of our very distinguished elders
for a minute.
Otumba Awofeso of the 1972 set. Wow. He's been resident in the United States for close to 40 years now.
Oh my goodness.
But he almost always comes to any event at St. Finbar's College. Sir, whoa, please stand up and take
please
a bow, sir.
Let us, not just a bow, let us hear one or two. You know, these people talk dollars.
US dollars.
US dollars. He talks US dollars. Yes.
Well, I'm happy to be here today. It is a honor to be a Finbarian and to be in the presence of all of you. I've already made one donation already,
yes,
which is in the records. I am glad to add another $250,000.
Whoa!
Naira.
250,000 naira.
You should have left it the way it was, sir. You should have left it. You should have left it. We already recorded your first take. So I was saying that we have the forms, the pledge forms. Please fill out the pledge forms. We really would depend on you to help us out there. It's almost time for dinner. I'm hungry. I don't know about you, But where's the lady? Where's the fair lady? She's so attached to me now. Come on, dear. Yeah, there we are. So it's dinner time, and I'll just thank you very much, dear. I'll see you after the show, okay? Bye. So
wait, so don't be too numb in a hurry. Somebody might do that dollar thing that we're talking about. I suspect him.
Okay.
Thank you, Patrick. Because of time, let me stand. Yeah, let me stand on the existing protocol. St. Finbar's College actually made me who I am today.
Wow. Wow. You are not alone.
I owe virtually all I've acquired in life to the discipline, the strict discipline that was impacted at St. Finbar's College. Some of you know me, some probably don't. I grew up at the Mayon Barrack here in Lagos. I'm sure you know what it means to grow up in the barrack. Other ranks for that matter, not a senior military officer.
Like the general.
As God will have it, my mom and my dad are here with us today.
Whoa. All right.
Can they stand up for recognition, please? Well, I don't know where they are. Barrister Paul Okohwe and Mrs.
Okay, there they are.
Yes.
Give them a round of applause. A round of applause for our lovely parents.
It might interest you to know.
Wow, talk about support.
It might interest you to know that my dad and I were actually in school together at the same time, because he had to drop out from, was it primary or secondary school?
You started too early.
And he wrote his GCE via exam success. I'm sure some of us know what exam success is.
Yes.
So we sat down and read together. While he was reading, I was also studying at the same time. Mm. I used to trek all the way from my own barracks to St. Finbar's College, a distance of about 40 minutes, and trek back. And as at that time, you come in late, you're in very serious trouble with Father Slattery. That imbibed that spirit of discipline and time consciousness in me, which I've carried on till this day.
Okay.
Unfortunately, I only had one pair of school uniform, you know, it was white on white. And so my routine was, once I get home, quickly enter the bathroom, take my bath and wash the uniform, leave it for the next day, iron it and go to school. But when I became the assistant head boy, my parents bought me an extra uniform and I was quite happy. But unfortunately, that very morning, as I was preparing to don that uniform and go to school, I burnt it around the hem. I had to fold it that very morning. It became short. I'm sure none of my classmates ever knew why I came to school at that period with what appeared short, yet I did turn up. I was actually covering the torn area. But God, in his infinite goodness, has blessed me. He has taken me this far. Yesterday, I commissioned my brand new hospital here in Lagos, the second branch in the country. And so I have, it's called gynecope. It's, we're into minimal access surgery, but that's not the time to discuss all that. It's here in Lekki. You hear about, I mean, by 10 o'clock this night, it'll be on Channel News.
Advert rates.
On Channel News,
rates.
Yes. So, yes.
So, have the advert rates with you?
Yes. So, I just want to say thank you to St. Finbar's College for all it has done for me.
Thank you.
I know I've spent so much money this period. I've given you something among whatever you anonymously gave, a token, but I still want to add the sum of 1 million naira to you.
Whoa! Whoa! And you know what? You know what? The difference between the two of us was that my dad almost caught up with me in school. I was just slightly ahead of him. Yeah? Okay, we have a gentleman round off. I am famished. I'm hungry. So can we do this in 5 minutes? Please, no long speeches. No long. I'm going to time your speeches. 30 seconds.
Thank you. Please, I'm compelled to stand with time.
Yes.
My intention was to channel my donation through him, but since he's spoken, I came all the way from Port Harcourt with my wife. We are going to support Professor Jill Chalila's contribution through him for $500,000.
Wow. Wow.
Thank you.
I knew something was going to land.
Because I left school about 45 years ago.
5 decades ago.
About 45 years ago. And as a preteen,
my moment of fame,
to attend St. Finbar's College.
Yeah.
And the reason they brought him here is to ensure that he doesn't involve one of our pride.
Yes.
He is a neurosurgeon and reputed to be one of the best neurosurgeons in the United States of America.
Yes.
I present to you,
yes,
Dr. Chinne Logan, neurosurgeon.
Thank you. Please wait. Yeah.
Good evening.
All right.
I feel so embarrassed.
When I grow up, I'm going to sound like that too.
But
hey, what's up?
Well,
hey, y'all.
I just want to thank you for having me here, and I'm excited to be here. I will tell you that the main reason I joined SF COBA is actually because of Dr. John Walsh. He'll stand up there.
Thank you.
I don't have much to say. I am blessed. I never got to meet Father Slattery, and I think his legacy continues to reign in me. Don't have much money, but I'm happy to donate the sum of 5 million naira.
Whoa! Whoa! Pato! 5,000 naira, sir. Pato never give me.
Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, as I said, there is, you know, Finbar's was a Catholic school. They taught us a little bit of Latin in Finbar's.
Yes.
A little bit. So I will go into this Latin phraseology here to describe what has happened. You just simply say, in Latin, you simply say, wait now, for what he has done.
Talk too much.
He says, Dada Oleja, Shubon, Ola Buro, Togoju. So those of you who understand Latin, you will know what I'm talking about. For our Irish friends who don't speak Latin, someone will interpret it for you, but Dada Koleja.
Please, Shubon, Ola Buro, Togoju.
So thank you very much. Dinner is served.
Patrick talks too much. See, person won't give $5 million just now. You know, just come and say, hey, I'm not gonna go to my deep meat for a slaughter, you know, I give 5 million. Well, there's a poor man.
Okay. We have a donation from the 2004 set, yes, for 250,000.
Whoa! Can we have a round of applause for them? A round of applause.
And aside from the one from the set, yes, a member of the set on his own,
yes,
Samson Akinyi, is also donating 250,000 in his personal capacity.
A round of applause.
Thank you very much. Applause. So, ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served. I beg.
Now, what's going to happen is that for dinner, we will start with the tables at the front. That's the first two rows. And we have serving points for the first set of tables. That's the first two rows in the corner to your left. And then we can, at the same time, commence service.
The last two rows the buffet table.
So I hope the ladies are listening. So you start from the table where we have the chairman, okay?
So, usher, please usher the table with the chairman to the buffet.
Yes, and then Logan's table. Logan's table is worth how many dollars? I think we should start from that table, Seth. That table is in dollars. So, Okay, so we have plenty. We have plenty for you.
And ladies and gentlemen, then we have another 5 million naira donation.
Whoa, please
from
move
Adeleke
to
Adeleke Atekoja.
Move to that table. Move to that table.
Adeleke Atekoja.
Move to that table.
Another
there.
5 million naira donation.
Whoa, all right. Man, I have to choose my friends carefully.
All right, so as we say, dinner itself, immediately after which we'll be doing the award ceremony. And we have a lot of our awards.
We play our times.
We play our times.
And race and run.
And race and run.
I'll tell you why.
I'll tell you why.
For love of gain.
For love of gain.
Ahigbe is there.
Ahigbe is there. Logan is there. Deleke is here.
Delede is there. For love of game.
Hey, Shobe Sangarwa.
Hey. Hey, Shobe Sangarwa. Hey, Shobe Sangarwa.
We are Fimberians.
We shall never lose.
We are Fimberians.
We shall never lose.
Once we wear the bright colors of St. Fimbers,
we shall never lose.
Orchestra time for our wonderful St. Fimbers College Orchestra.
So, Your Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, at this point, we will be leaving this stage for a minute as we introduce the school band to come up here, take their positions, and entertain us with what we never enjoyed when we were in school. When we were in school, we used to beat our, from the Paco department, we used to knock the wood on our tables. But today, you can see the difference. We've made a transformation, roundabout 360 degrees transformation for our young ones. We never were able to maintain clean shoes like this. Our shoes always came out dirty. But hey, look at what has happened. This is the new St. Fimbers College. The boys are going to entertain us. I want you all to welcome them with open hearts. Let's give them a round of applause as we see our future, the future of this great country, Nigeria. The young lads from St. Fimbers College. DJ, please take that music down. Let's hear the original. Yeah? Great. So take it away.
Thank you. what you can do. I dialed the right number, but I still couldn't get through. Will you just check the line just one more time if you can? I'm pretty sure my phone can be answered by no man.
Hello. All right. So here we are. Where did we stop? Food. Okay. So we'll continue from where we stopped. I know that some of us are still enjoying our meal. Are you all enjoying your meals? Aha. I thought so too. So we have to be a little strategic about this now. We've lost quite some time, so we will quickly dive into the next item. Thank you. How did you guess? Thank you. So, we will dive into the next item, which is the awards, actually. We have the a citation of the awardees, which we will run on the screen. We want you to pay attention to all of these awardees. And for the first set of awards, and I think we have the DC Awards. DC will be Distinguished Conqueror. The Distinguished Conqueror Award, we will start with that. And I'd like to call His Grace. Nope, he's not here. Who's doing the presentation? Yeah. Okay. I'd like to ask our chairman, Senator Adefuye, Anthony Adefuye, to kindly join us on the stage at this end
to do the presentation of the DC Award, first to Major our dear Senator, sir. Okay. Okay. The chairman will join us in a minute, but we'd like to have the citation. Okay. General, Major General Adeleke Anyonuga is a member of the St. Famous College class of 1986. He will be the first recipient of the award for the Distinguished Conqueror, which is indeed the highest honor from the St. Famous College Old Boys Association to be given to anyone. General, with all respect, sir, we'd like to invite you. Yes. We'd like to invite you here. I'd like a round of applause for Major General Adeleke Anyonuga, a member of the St. Fimbas College class of 1986. This way, sir. Yes, 1986. This way. Oh, of course, certainly. Oh, yes. She is the general. In fact, she is the major general. Eh? Eh? Ahead, yes. Ah, I know. For photo ops, could you just move a little closer this way so that we can capture the backdrop? I don't want to be in this one. People are always running after me with their cameras everywhere I go. We'll do the citation first. No. You stay there. We'll stay there with General. Madame doesn't mind. She understands. Can we have the General's citation just for a minute? And then we'll do the presentation of the plaque.
13th of February 1969 in Lagos. He attended Akoka Primary School, Akoka, and St. Finbar's College, Akoka, from 1981 to 1986. On the 12th of September 1987, he gained admission into the Nigerian Defense Academy as a member of the 39th Regular Corps, where he obtained a BSc in Mathematics and was commissioned as a second lieutenant into the Nigerian Army Signals in 1992. He is also an alumnus of the Obafemi Awolowo University, Ife, where he obtained a diploma in Telecommunications Engineering in 1997 and a BSc in Electrical and Electronics Engineering in 1999. General Anyonuga achievements in his illustrious career. Notable ones include military assistant to the Commander Corps of Signals, APAPA, United Nations military observer in the Democratic Republic of Congo, a commanding officer of the 540 Signals Regiment in Enugu. He was also a directing staff and subsequently chief instructor at the prestigious Armed Forces Command and Staff College, Jaji Kaduna, where he was conferred with the highly cherished award of PASS Staff Corps, DAGA. He is currently the commander, Nigerian Army Cyber Warfare Command. His military honors, awards, and decorations include the Forces Service Star, Meritorious Service Star, Distinguished Service Star, Grand Service Star, United Nations Medal, Past Staff College Dagger, Command Medal, Field Command Medal, and Nigerian Army Research Medal. He is also an International Fellow of the National Day. He is married to Ogoluwa Anyonuga.
Okay, so before we do the presentation, I would just like to let you all know that I was also a member of the Boy Scout. So, us. Just that we salute with three fingers. Yours is the whole thing. All right, sir. Would you like the microphone?
Major General Adeleke A. Anyonuga, I present you with this flag of the Distinguished Conqueror DC Award. Congratulations. Lieutenant General. Really?
Yes,
you should have come in your military uniform too. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
Good. You're in the military too.
No, in the military, our wives are usually.
Okay, well, yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Can I go?
No, you're doing two more.
So, President, please do take pictures with them. Okay, madam, I hope everything is in order. Thank you very much. Yes, because, you know, our wives are very powerful. Even with all that uniform, by the time they reach house. Okay, not be me talk, Amo. I'd like to invite Dr. David Ige, member of the St. Fimbres College class of 1982. Could you please put our hands together for him, Dr. David Ige? And I don't know why I smell oil all over him. Oil? Dollars. Oh, dollars. It's dollars I should be spending. Dr. Ige, you're welcome. Nice having you, sir. Thank you. So, our chairman, we will ask for Dr. Ige's citation now for a few minutes. So let's unmask him. Yes.
Dr. David Ige is the founder and CEO of Gas Invest Limited and Gas Hub Limited. He has over 30 years of oil and gas industry experience, spanning both the private and public sector. Prior to Gas Invest Limited, David held various roles, including Group Executive Director. Dr. David Ige is the founder and CEO of Gas Invest Limited and Gas Hub Limited. He has over 30 years of oil and gas industry experience, spanning both the private and public sector. Prior to Gas Invest Limited, David held various roles, including Group Executive Director, Gas and Power at the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, Advisor to the Honorable Minister of Petroleum, Managing Director of the Gas Aggregation Company of Nigeria. Earlier in his career, he worked as petroleum engineer with Shell International Petroleum Company in the Netherlands, in Scotland, and in Nigeria. Whilst in public service at the NNPC, David led the development and implementation of Nigeria's Gas Master Plan. Over the years, he has also held diverse board positions, including member of the board of NNPC, board member of the Brass LNG Company. David belongs to the St. Fimbres College class of 1982. He holds a first class BSc in Mechanical Engineering from the University of Lagos, a PhD in Engineering from Cambridge University, UK, and an MBA from the University of Aberdeen, Scotland. He's a fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. David is also author of the book Understanding Natural Gas in Nigerian Perspective. He teaches the postgraduate class Gas Policy and Energy Economics at the University of Ibadan and at the Emerald Energy Institute at the University of Port Hackett.
Familiar. Remember we met when we were advising the president on oil and gas in 1982. You got it. So we'll do the presentation now, and we'll try and speed up this process. Yes.
Dr. David
Oluseyi Ige. I present you with this plaque as Distinguished Conqueror and Benefactor, DCB Award. Congratulations.
I would like to, please, this is, you are now a DCB, Distinguished Conqueror and Benefactor. Thank you very much.
May I now kindly request for Pastor Emeka Obiago, who's a member of the St. Fimbres College, class of 1980. Put our hands together for him. Emeka Obiago. Okay. Thank you, madam, for bringing him. Thank you for bringing him. Yes. You know, ordinarily, we wouldn't have been able to get Emeka himself. But we spoke directly with madam and said she approved our application for him to be here this evening. Thank you so much. May we have his citation for a few minutes? Let's unmask him. 1980. I don't come out school that time. No, 1980. Ah, wait. No, I left in 75. Yes, you were still in diapers that time. You were still wearing nappy. You still did. Eh? Let's have his citation, please. Let's move fast on this. Pastor Emeka Obiago.
Chukwu Emeka Obiago is a multidisciplinary professional with a background in accounting, insurance, corporate finance, stockbroking, and public finance. He has over 3 decades of experience in banking, financial services, and the public sector, the bulk of which was spent in Fidelity Bank PLC, where he rose from assistant manager position to general manager and regional bank head. Whilst in Fidelity Bank, he had stints in operations, human resources, and corporate services. Early in his career at Fidelity Bank PLC, Obiago successfully repositioned and grew a subsidiary, which he eventually led as the group managing director and chief executive. He was also a non-executive director of Fidelity Pension Managers, where he also served as the chairperson of the board audit committee. Ms. Obiago worked as director enforcement with the Federal Inland Revenue Service, FIRS, from January 2016 to January 2021. While at the FIRS, he also served as a member of the technical committee, the board, and the chairperson of the budget committee of the FIRS. In April 2021, Mr. Chukwu Emeka Obiago was appointed to the board of Wema Bank PLC as an executive director responsible for the North and East Directorate of the bank. An alumnus of the Lagos Business School, Obiago also obtained an executive certificate in economic development from the Harvard University Kennedy School of Government in Boston, Massachusetts, USA. He also attended various executive business education courses and reputable institutions, including Harvard Business School, Kellogg School of Management, and the Wharton Business School, as well as the University of Chicago Booth School of Business, among others. Mr. Obiago is a fellow of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria, ICAN, a fellow of the Chartered Institute of Stockbrokers, and honorary senior member of the Chartered Institute of Bankers of Nigeria, a fellow of the Chartered Institute of Taxation, and an associate of the Chartered Insurance Institute in London.
Reverend Father Anthony.
I would have loved to be your friend, but that FIRS bit. You're a tax man. Even in the Bible. Okay, we'll do the presentation now.
Pastor Emeka Obiagu, I hereby present you with the plaque of Distinguished Conqueror and Benefactor, DCB Award. Congratulations. Please decorate your husband.
Okay. Just one more, sir. Professor Ayodeji Ayotunde Oluwole, he's a member of the St. Fimbres College class of 1983. If Pastor Emeka was in diapers, Professor Oluwole was not even wearing anything at the time I left school. You're welcome. And Madame is here. Sorry, I didn't know you were here too. So that joke, I shouldn't have cracked that kind of joke with Madame around. So could we please have the citation? Let's have the citation.
Professor Ayodeji Ayotunde Oluwole is a consultant obstetrician and gynecologist at the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology of the Lagos University Teaching Hospital Idiaraba, Surulere, and associate professor of the College of Medicine, University of Lagos. He started his primary education at the St. Patrick's Primary School, Yaba, and he proceeded to the St. Finbar's College for his secondary school education, and he had his A-levels at the International School, Ibadan, before proceeding to the Ogun State University, where he obtained an MBCH medical degree. He proceeded to do his postgraduate residency program at the University Teaching Hospital, Idiaraba, between 1998 and 2003. Before proceeding to the United States for his subspecialty training at the Abbott Northwestern University, Minneapolis, Minnesota, in January 2004. He was posted to the Lagos Island Maternity Hospital upon his arrival back in Nigeria in September 2004, before being employed as a lecturer and consultant at the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology, Faculty of Clinical Sciences, College of Medicine, University of Lagos, and the Lagos University Teaching Hospital Idiaraba, Surulere, from April 2005 till date. He is a maternal medicine subspecialist and gynecology endoscopic surgeon with 18 years experience working as a specialist. And he became the chairman medical advisory committee of LUTH from June 2023 till date. He is a visiting consultant to St. Nicholas Hospital and NNPC Hospital, Lagos. He is happily married with 4 children.
In other words, Professor Ayodeji Ayotunde Oluwole is one of those who they will refer to as Igiwe. Yeah? So let's have the presentation.
Professor Ayodeji Ayotunde Oluwole, I hereby present to you the Distinguished Conqueror DCB Award. Congratulations. Hello.
Hey, boy. Would you meet me on the roof tonight?
Please, decorate your husband. Senators, just one more to go. And let me quickly invite Professor Jude Okohwe, he is a member of the St. Finbar's College class of 1988. Was he even born? Was he born when I left school? Professor Jude Okohwe, you're welcome. Please, let's give him a round of applause. He's the gentleman who just decorated us with millions of naira a short while ago. Madam, thanks for approving that support. I know that without you, that wouldn't have been possible. Thank you. So, if you just move this way, so we can get you properly framed in our picture. You are the celebrants. You are the celebrants for the day. Please, mommy. Come. Yes. Please come upstairs. Please give them a round of applause. And you know, what really gets me is that they even attended this event with their son. Wow. Wow. Round of applause. Thank you. Dad, thank you, Mom. Can we, let's have the citation now. Mommy, oh, watch out, mama. Anybody can eat I call back, I call, let's say, whatever. So let's have the citation, please. Let's have the citation.
Professor Jude Okohwe attended the army. He was appointed assistant head boy, and he emerged as the overall best graduating student in the 19th medicine and surgery certificate in 1996 from the University of Benin. As a result of his sterling performance, Professor Okohwe received the Plateau State Governor's Award for the best youth copper in 1999. Jude's huge appetite for knowledge led him to obtain a diploma and a fellowship certificate in minimal access surgery from the World Laparoscopy Hospital and the European Society and Seven, thus becoming the first Nigerian to benefit from the Society of Gynecology and Obstetrics of Nigeria and the Nordic Federation of Obstetrics and Gynecology Twinning Program. Professor Jude Okohwe founded a fertility and endoscopy facility in April 2010, named Gynoscope Specialist Hospital in Port Hackett, Rivers State. The Lekki Lagos branch of the Gynoscope Specialist Hospital was commissioned yesterday on the 24th of September. Professor Okohwe has also been involved in the teaching of undergraduate medical students and postgraduate doctors. He has published over 60 articles in several internationally indexed journals, written several books, and served as an editorial board member in numerous international journals. Professor Okohwe has been happily married for over 21 years to his best friend and pillar of support, Joy.
I think we have to get something right here. I'm not sure that the name is properly pronounced. I would imagine that name would be something like Okohwe. So let's get it right. We'll do the presentation now. And yes.
Professor Jude E. Okowe. I present you with the Distinguished Conqueror and Benefactor, DCB Award. Please present your husband. Congratulations. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And I'd like to thank our chairman. We kept you on your feet for quite a while. Thank you so much for doing us that honor. We will move on to the next set of awards, which will be the DC Awards, Distinguished Conquerors Award. And the first recipient on this page will be Engineer Francis Ogwamanam. Engineer Francis Ogwamanam, I want you to note his infectious smile. I want you to note his infectious smile. Please come up, sir. And older boys, okay. I have been reliably informed that he is not quite an ancestor yet. He is simply an older boy. Because he's a member of the St. Fimbres College class of 1967. 1967. We were almost classmates. I missed it by just 15 years. I'd like to call Mr. Shegun Ajanlekoko to kindly come up and do this round of presentations for us. Ah, class of 1967. What? Did they have blackboards at that time? I'm sure you guys were sitting on the floor or something. No? Wow. And you're still looking trim. Madam, what's the magic? Grace of God, that's the magic. Okay, after grace of God, Unko?
I don't know.
Grace of wife. Sir, so could we roll the citation for the gentleman, Engineer Francis Ogwamanam?
Engineer Francis Ogwamanam was born in Lagos in October in the year 1948. He attended St. Paul's Catholic Primary School, Apapa Road, St. Fimbres College, Akoka, where he left in 1967 in his final year as a result of the Nigerian Civil War. He came back to study civil engineering and graduated with honors from the University of Lagos. Upon completion of his NYSC program in 1976, he was employed by Messrs. Ove Arup and Partners, one of the foremost reputable consulting engineering firms of those days, where he was involved in the design and supervision of the following projects, amongst others: the Tafar Balewa Square Complex, Lagos; Guinness Factory, Ogba; UCH Ibadan Gynecological Wards. In 1981, he left Ove Arup as a senior engineer and was employed by Messrs. Harbour Works and seconded to its Netherlands head office. where he was a member of the design team for the Apapa Port Slipway and the design of the infrastructural facilities of the Snake Island, Lagos and Burutu in Delta State. In between the assignment, he obtained a postgraduate diploma in marine structures from the Delft University in the Netherlands. He came back to Nigeria in 1983, and in 1985 he left the private sector and joined the services of the Lagos State Government New Towns Development Authority. In 1984, he established the Materials Testing Laboratory at Ojodu. He was deployed again in 1999 as Director of Project Management at the Parastatals Monitoring Office and retired in that position in 2001. Upon retirement, he established an engineering consultancy outfit, GOF Engineering Services. Engineer Ogwamanam is a chartered engineer of the Council of Engineering Institutions and member of the Institution of Civil Engineers UK. Is registered with the Council for the Regulation of Engineering in Nigeria, CORIN, in 1983. Was a member of the Institution of Highways Transportation of the UK, 1984, and is a fellow of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. Francis is married to Mrs. Florence Ogwamanam, who also served as a director at the Inspectorate Division of the Lagos State Ministry of Education.
That's what they've been doing in government. No, so all that engineering, and I think in one word, let's just sum this all up. To best describe this gentleman here, I think we should just call him an engine. He's just an engine. Because everything engineering is too much. So.
I got to know Engineer Francis when we entered St. Finbarr's. We thought we were age mates, so you know he was very small then. But he used to frown his eyes and say, "We are your senior here." And ever since, I used to fear him. But he's a jolly good fellow. And he's done for Nigerian Society of Engineers numerous things, which you now must translate into St. Finbarr's College. He has an endowment for so many things. I monitor you. He has a grand something in engineering, if I'm correct. And you cannot run away from St. Finbarr's Akoka, where you started from. So on behalf of the St. Finbarr College Old Boys Association, and in recognition of your benevolence and outstanding support for the development and transformation of St. Finbarr's College, Akoka, and raising the profile and effectiveness of St. Finbarr's College Old Boys Association. Today, 25th day of September 2023, you have been awarded the Distinguished Conqueror's Award. Congratulations. As an emblem of your new status, you are going to be decorated with this muffler by your wife, and you must wear it all the time. It could be inconveniencing like it is for me, but you must wear it. It's a sign of honor. So please, madam, decorate your husband. The other way around. Is that all? Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. The next gentleman is a personal friend of mine, and I don't know why you brought his wife today. I would have made some confessions on his behalf. But John Wise. Please let's welcome John Wise, MBE. He's a member of the St. Finbar's College, class of 1976. John Wise. John Wise.
I don't know where my baby is.
Wise.
But I'll find him.
John Wise. Johnny, why you bring, why you allow madam follow you?
I'll never give up looking for
my she knows. You think she knows everything? You think you know? You think you know everything? We are not talking about prefect. We are talking about Our Lady of Apostles. Fuck your ears.
Mr. John Wise, MBE, a member of the class of 1976. Mr. John Wise, MBE, has 3 decades of experience working in management. He was honored by Her Majesty the Queen, Elizabeth II, before her demise, with the award of the MBE, Member of the Order of the British Empire, for exceptional services to Her Majesty's government overseas. He is currently a consultant in logistics and supply chain management. He is happily married and is blessed with 3 children.
Slap anybody and say, John Wise is my friend.
One of the institutions I cherish most is the Royal Institution. I've been privileged to have dinner with the late Queen twice. It's commendable, and it shows the Finbar spirit. Today, you have been given the highest award that the old boys could give, Distinguished Corporal, in recognition of your benevolence and outstanding support for the development and transformation of St. Finbar's College, Akoka, Lagos, and raising the profile and effectiveness of St. Finbar's College Old Boys Association. Congratulations. Madam, you do this. You decorate your husband I know he always bowed down for you. Many congratulations.
Thank you very much. May I have another round of applause? John Wise, you're welcome. So, could you turn that down? Please, could you turn that down? It's confession time. It's confession time now. All my sins that I've committed all day, we will now confess on stage. I'd like to invite Reverend Father, Professor Anthony Akinwale. He is a member of the St. Finbar's College class of 1979. 1979. Yes, and he's here with sister. Yes. Okay. Another round of applause for him as he comes up. Okay, Papa Okufure. Yeah, and he's been accompanied by Papa Okufure, who used to be rector. Yeah, this way, sir. No. Yes. It's okay, sir. I can get one of the young ladies to help you up the stairs. I know. Aha. Welcome, sir. Thank you so much. Thanks for coming. I think before, could you turn that music down? There's breaking news here that the young man that we see here is just 93 years. And indeed, I've been ably informed that he is indeed the first rector of the Yaba College of Technology. Welcome. Daddy, thank you so much. So we will do the citation for Professor Reverend Father, and so we can move on. Could we have his citation, please?
Reverend Father Anthony Alaba Akinwale was born in Ebute Metta, Lagos on the 10th of June 1962. He had his nursery education at Mount Carmel Nursery School, Ebute Metta, Lagos from 1966 to 1968. His primary education at St. Paul's Catholic School, Ebute Metta, 1968 to 1974. And secondary education at St. Finbar's College, Akoka, from 1974 to 1979. He made his first profession in the Order of Preachers on September 27, 1981, and was ordained to the Catholic priesthood in December 20, 1987. Prior to his priestly ordination, he studied philosophy at the seminary of Saints Peter and Paul, Bodija, Nigeria, and theology at the Catholic Faculty of Theology, now known as the Catholic University of Kinshasa in the Democratic Republic of Congo. After his priestly ordination, he worked in the Catholic Diocese of Sokoto before proceeding to the Dominican University College in Ottawa, Canada, where he obtained his licentiate and master's degree in theology in 1991. He obtained his Doctor of Philosophy degree in Systematic Theology at the Boston College, USA in 1996. During his doctoral studies, he began his teaching career at the Boston College in 1993 and returned to Nigeria in 1996 to teach at the Dominican Institute, where he rose to become Professor of Systematic Theology in 2006. He served as Pioneer Dean of Studies from 1996 to the year 2000 and President of the Dominican Institute from 2004 to 2016. Professor Akinwale has authored 3 books. He is currently preparing for the publication of a book titled In Search of Nationhood, Essays on Nigerian Politics. He has co-edited 3 books and authored over 100 academic essays and conference papers in national and international journals. In August 2017, the Board of Trustees of the Dominican University appointed him Pioneer Vice Chancellor of the Dominican University Ibadan, the first university of the Dominican Order in Africa. He completed his term as Vice Chancellor in August 2022 and is currently at the Department of Philosophy and Religious Studies, Faculty of Humanities, Management and Social Sciences at the Augustine University, Ilara Ekpe in Lagos State. On February 23, 2023, having received a positive assessment of his publications from a team of chosen experts, the Master of the Order of Preachers conferred on him the ancient academic title of Magister in Sacra Theologia, the highest academic title in the order that it confers on its intellectuals. Professor Akinwale speaks Yoruba, English and French, and has a reading knowledge of Latin, Greek, Hebrew, Italian, Spanish, German, and Hausa.
What more can you add to that?
I really don't know what to say.
Very effective. And so it's heartwarming to see him here. And you can trace why Father Akiwale is who he is today when you see someone like Paul Kufre. So it is indeed a joy that may the Lord grant you long life, more long life. You have so many children that you've born into the world, and I think ICANN cannot exist without your name. You brought the accountancy to the front burner of in Nigeria. So nice to have you here and to witness the award to this proficient Reverend Father. If there's one thing that Father Slattery has, Reverend Father, but he has followed Father Slattery's footpath. And today, in recognition of that, your extreme academic excellence, benevolence, and outstanding religious career, St. Finbar's College Akoka Old Boys Association is giving you this highest award of distinguished conqueror, raising the profile and effectiveness of St. Finbar's College Old Boys Association. Many congratulations.
Yeah, it's not over yet.
The Reverend Sister will do it in the absence of a wife.
Okay. Not able to come here for his award. Please, can we do that? We'll do that quickly, and then we have. Pastor Obiagu is collecting on behalf of Wilson. I may have to call the Board of Trustees chairman back. Where is he? National President, could you please step in for us? Okay, may I ask that Fumio Adenosh, please come up. I don't want us to lose any steam here. And as we do that, I'd like to recognize the presence of the chairman of the Copyright Association of Nigeria, Sir Chief Tony Okoroji, who's here with us. Thanks for coming, sir. Thank you so much. Okay, so here we are. Dr. Wilson Orihenu, can we citation?
Dr. Wilson Orihenu, 5 and 1980. He went on to study medicine at the University of Benin, after which he migrated to the United Kingdom. Wilson is a cane writer and is the author of the first online Nigerian Pidgin English Dictionary, Babawili Dictionary of Pidgin Words, and counts researching Nigerian history as one of his hobbies. He regularly runs marathons and half marathons to raise money for various charities. His love for adventure has seen him embark on a mountain trek up the Mount Kilimanjaro for charity. He also climbed Snowdon Mountain Wales in 2021. And finally, Wilson climbed Chapel Wadi Mountain, Nigeria's highest point, in 2022. In 2004, Dr. Orihenu received a merit award in recognition of his charity work at the Nigerian Achievers Night held in London. In 2022, with the help of his classmates in the 1980 set, Wilson organized a symposium at the school for the students where he spoke to them about writing and a career in medicine.
Sleep at all. I wonder if he sleeps. Okay, let's do the presentation on his. That's the reason why he couldn't come. He's busy climbing some mountain somewhere. Oh.
Well, it will look like 1980 set is dominating today's awards. Congratulations to 1980 set. I want to believe that Dr. Wilson Ohiono is watching via the live stream. Congratulations to him. And it's my privilege and honor, in recognition of your benevolence and outstanding support for the development and transformation of St. Finbar's College at Akoka and raising the profile and effectiveness of SF Koba. Congratulations as we award you Distinguished Conqueror. That's the highest award of SF Koba. Congrats.
So his wife, when this gets to the UK, his wife will decorate him with this and send us the picture. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So I'd like to quickly call Mr. Adetola Atekoja. You are next. Okay, could you hold on a second, sir? The president just overruled. So I'm inviting Mr. Patrick Doyle, DC, National President of the Association, to kindly come up and let's do the presentation. Presentations. First to Gerald Ilukwe. Gerald, is Gerald around? Aha. Oh, okay. Yeah. That's Gerald Ilukwe. I was looking out for you and quite frankly, I didn't recognize you when I saw you earlier. Can you imagine that? Good to see you. Good to see you. I'm so sorry I didn't recognize. Yeah, so could we have plaque? Where's this plaque? Please come up quickly. Let's have his citation now. Let's have the citation.
Gerald Ilukwe currently serves as a Special Advisor ICT and Chief Information Officer at the Kaduna State Government. Prior to his appointment, he was Managing Director of Knowledge Resources Limited, an ICT consulting and solutions firm he founded in 2016. He served for 8 years as a Pioneer Chief Executive Officer and Managing Director of Galaxy Backbone Limited, the ICT company of responsibility for West Africa, and his career path includes Motorola Solutions, SAP, and IBM. Gerald has served on several high-level federal government committees, including the Technical Committee for the Establishment of the National Identity Management Commission, Nigeria Vision 2020 Committee, Petroleum Revenue Task Force, and Integrated Personnel and Payroll Information System, IPPIS. He also serves on the board of several companies. His efforts in transforming the acquisition and use of ICT in the Nigerian public sector have been widely recognized, and under his leadership, Galaxy Backbone won first prize for the African region in the United Nations Public Service Awards for 2013. He holds a first degree in electronic engineering, a master's in business administration. He's an alumnus of the Harvard University Kennedy School of Government. He's also attended executive education programs on leadership, innovation, partnership, venture capital, and IT leadership from the London Business School, the INSEAD Business School France, Haas School of Business, University of California, Berkeley, and the CIO Institute, Mellon University, Virginia.
I mean, Gerard, what do you imagine that I will add to that?
There's nothing.
You covered all the areas in ICT. Let's give him. Let's just give him a round of applause. This is a well-rounded gentleman. He's a complete rounded gentleman.
So, on behalf of the National Executive of the St. Vimbus College All Boys Association, I present you this plaque. And you are hereby decorated with the muffler as a distinguished conqueror. Suffice to say, Gerald is of the 1980 set. And if you notice, the 1980 set has produced quite a few DCs today. And that's because of Gerald's untiring efforts at making sure that there's rapprochement between the 1980 set and the National Secretariat. So a round of applause for this great man, who, without whom, we probably wouldn't even have an association. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So, Martin. Yes, may I quickly call on Martin Olomofe? Okay, Martin Olomofe, he's a member of the St. Famous College class of 1980, and he is ably represented by Anefiok Johnson and Wale Adefuye. I think one will be the wife, the other one will be brother. So the important thing is that you come here and receive it.
Back to life, back to reality. Back to
okay,
life,
you are his wife. They say you are his wife. Reality, you are not his wife. Okay. The citation, please. For Martin Olomofe.
Martin Olomofe of the 1980 set is a chartered surveyor with varied expertise and experience in valuation, corporate real estate, and strategic asset management gained from the private and public sectors. Martin graduated from the Polytechnic Ibadan with a HND in Estate Management. He proceeded to the United Kingdom in 1989, where he acquired postgraduate certification as well as enrolled membership of the Royal Institution of Chartered Surveyors. He is currently the head of property for the London Borough of Camden and holds a master's in business administration. Martin was a founding member of the St. Fimbres College All Boys Association Europe chapter and served as the general secretary for a number of years. Martin is happily married to his sweetheart, Tonya, and they have two sons.
Wait, before you go, in those days when they tell us to go and study, to read our books, this Patrick Doyle, he will drag me to Interhouse Sports. CCV, did you hear his CV? Please go. This Patrick Doyle. Okay, let's call Oladapo Akande Akinosun SAN. He's a member of the St. Famous College class of 1981. 1981. Please put your hands together for him. Gentlemen. Yeah, the full package. Never mind. You know what he said? He said he's much younger than those old men. You know one thing about Father Slattery? Okay, I'll tell you something. About 2 weeks ago, I attended the birthday party of one of my classmates. He turned 70. I'm 64. And this guy sat quietly in class with us, about 6 years older than the average. But you see, Father Slattery made it possible for so many people. I know there are some of them in here now. So he made it possible for so many people to join us in school. Can we have the citation? I like your tie, Sha. Wait a second.
Dakpo Akinosun is a senior advocate of Nigeria and one of the founding partners of Siemens Cooper Partners, a leading commercial law firm in Nigeria. In addition to his legal practice, Dakpo is passionate about teaching, and he founded the highly acclaimed mooting competition called Siemens Cooper Advocacy Development, SCAD. Throughout his career, Dakpo has advised corporations, governments, and not-for-profit organizations on a range of legal and policy matters, including competition law, consumer protection, debt management, and privatization initiatives in the power sector. Dakpo appreciates the link between law, development, and the general socio-economic exchange. His personal career objective is to explore how the law can be used to bring quick, positive, and practical solutions to his immediate sphere of influence. He is also a co-author of the book, Understanding Natural Gas, A Nigerian Perspective. Dakpo holds a postgraduate degree in gas law, liquefied natural gas, LNG, from the BC Academy, UK, and has undertaken an executive business program at Harvard Business School. He's a notary public and a member of the International Bar Association, the Nigerian Bar Association, the American Bar Association, the Nigerian Gas Association, and Chartered Arbitrators of the UK.
I'm not jealous, but it's all right. It's okay.
On behalf of the St. Vimbus College Old Boys Association and the National Executive of the Association, we present you with this plaque for your outstanding work in the field of, in the law. I wish I could, let me decorate you. And since your wife is not here, please let me do this.
Congratulations, well done. Thank you so much. So quickly, we'll call, and we're almost there. Just to let you know that buffet is still served. If we have people who arrived late or you feel like having another round of food, the buffet is still on. You can still serve yourselves. May I call Dr. Gregory Odutayo? Gregory Odutayo. Yeah, Gregory Odutayo. He's a member of the St. Famous College class of 1983. Class of 1983. Yes, sir. There he is. Yes, and he's a gentleman too. You're welcome, sir. Madam, congratulations. Well done. So, could we have the citation for this gentleman?
Gregory Odutayo is an entrepreneur of over 25 years. He is results-driven with a progressive management career in the creative industry. A highly effective communicator and team leader with proven ability to build long-term relationships with internal and external customers by establishing a high level of confidence and trust. A member of the 1983 set of St. Finbar's College and a graduate of theatre arts from the prestigious University of Ibadan, Greg, as he is fondly called, also has an executive education certificate from the Owner Manager Program 2 of the Lagos Business School, Pan African University, and a certificate in Agric Management Programs of the Lagos Business School. He also has a certificate in the Leadership and Governance in Media and Communication program of the School of Media and Communication of the Pan African University in Lagos, as well as the Entertainment Masterclass program. Greg is a consultant and training facilitator for the British Broadcasting Corporation Media Action Group and has facilitated several workshops and seminars for the British Council, the BBC Media Action Group, and the Nigerian Broadcasting Commission, among several others. A fellow of theatre arts and former national president of the National Association of Nigerian Theatre Arts Practitioners, NANTAP, Greg is the current managing director of Royal Roots Nigeria, comprising of Royal Roots Television, Royal Roots FM stations in Lagos and Ibadan, as well as Royal Roots Cinema, Lekki. He sits on the board of companies spanning the insurance and manufacturing sector in Nigeria. A visionary leader with a keen understanding of business priorities and demonstrated expertise in rapidly advancing business goals, and is skilled at developing and executing integrated, targeted business initiatives with a proven track record and driving growth. Gregory Odutayo, with over 30 years working experience that spans sectors in marketing communications, project management, and creative services, is a director and entrepreneur of repute in the creative industry in Nigeria. Greg is married to another icon of the creative industry, Deborah Odutayo, and their marriage is blessed with three boys.
I knew we shared a lot in common. Wow, we need to talk. Let me sell myself a bit. Should I sell myself a bit? He's a medium. He's my bro. Okay, so we'll talk later.
We'll talk to him later. I am particularly proud of Greg Odutayo because he has excelled in the field that I operate in. And it is gratifying to see an old boy of St. Finbar's College holding his own as a media entrepreneur. I am a media practitioner. He is a media entrepreneur, serial entrepreneur, and I think for that we should give him a round of applause. Thank you very much. Bless you. Auntie Deborah. Debbie is also an icon. She is one of the best audiovisual television film producers. She's an organizer-in-chief, and she's probably more responsible for his successes than we would like to think. So, Deborah, please decorate your husband. Okay, give him a kiss. Ah, thank you very much, Greg. Bless you. In my capacity as president of the Old Boys Association, I am summoning Tola Ate Koja to come on stage now and handle the next set of awards. Please, ladies and gentlemen, he was the chairman of the planning committee, and the success of today's event is largely due to his organizational abilities. He is a manager of men and resources. A round of applause for the chairman of our planning committee, Tola Ate Koja.
Thank you very much, my president, Mr. Ate Koja Kindly. I'd like to call the next person is actually Muiwa Odufalu. Muiwa Odufalu, and he's not here. He will be represented by Kingsley Chukwu of the 1987 set. He's the general secretary of the 1987 set. Thank you. So there we are. Could we have the citation for Muiwa Odufalu?
Olumuyiwa Odufalu, a visionary leader in the oil and gas industry. His journey in the sector is characterized by his remarkable achievements and transformative leadership. He holds a master's degree in architecture from the Obafemi Awolowo University, where he also earned his bachelor's degree. He is a member of the Project Management Institute, PMI, and the International Facility Management Association, IFMA. Odufalu, in his illustrious career, has held pivotal positions that have propelled him to the forefront of the industry. From his tenure as Managing Director, CEO of Zome Marine and Logistics Limited, to his role as the co-founder and CEO of Zethis Global Services Limited, where he spearheads a wide range of essential services to the oil and gas sector. Odufalu's accomplishments extend beyond the boardroom. His role as senior project engineer at Adax Petroleum showcased his dedication to corporate social responsibility, where he managed impactful projects that positively affected communities in Nigeria and Sao Tome. As an honoree at the award ceremony, Olumuyiwa Odufalu's remarkable journey and contribution stand as a testament to his unwavering commitment to excellence, his exceptional leadership, and his invaluable impact on the oil and gas sector.
On behalf of St. Finbar's Collegial Boys Association, we'd like to present this award to Olumuyiwa Oluwole Odufalu in recognition of your benevolence and outstanding support for the development and transformation of St. Finbar's College, Akoka, Lagos, and raising the profile and effectiveness of SFCOBA. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Quickly, well, we're almost there. We're almost done. We'll call Dr. Joshua Oshifeso. Dr. Joshua Oshifeso.
Joshua Adedayo Oshifeso is an experienced logistics and procurement specialist with a strong background in neurosurgery at Virginia Tech Carleton School of Medicine. He completed a combined fellowship in cerebrovascular and endovascular neurosurgery in Nashville, Tennessee, under the tutelage of renowned cerebrovascular expert Robert A. Merkel, MD. He later returned to Nashville to serve as the chief of neurosurgery at a now level one trauma center in Tennessee for 4 years. Dr. Logan is a board-certified neurosurgeon and a fellow of the American College of Surgeons and the American College of Osteopathic Surgeons. He is a board member of the Association of Nigerian Physicians in the Americas. Dr. Logan is the founder and president of the Katakitso Foundation, a non-profit philanthropic organization dedicated not only to providing medical care to people groups around the world, with an emphasis on providing medical education and ongoing training of indigenous providers who can carry on the ministry year-round. He is a member of the class of 1996 at the St. Finbar's College.
It's not real. You can't be human. How could you achieve all of that? You human?
I just work here.
You just work here. Let's give him the, let him get out of here. Extra, extra, read all about it.
Come on.
there's something about Dr. Logan. I wasn't at the party at Nashville. I missed the St. Finbar's College reunion party in America. I was at the last one in Atlanta. But from the information I gathered, he was such a good host that I was told that that was the best reunion of SFCOBA in North America. So thank you, Logan, for that. So on behalf of SFCOBA, in recognition of your benevolence and outstanding support for the development and transformation of St. Finbar's College, Akoka, Lagos, and raising the profile and effectiveness of St. Finbar's College All Boys Association, we present you with the DC Award. Please keep it up. We represent the future of SFCOBA.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Extra, extra, read all about it. I'm talking front page story all over the world. It shook up men, women, boys.
Thank you so much. And Dr. Logan. Well done, Dr. Logan. May we have another round of applause. That's, you know, exemplary. You know, it's terrific. Great show. Well done, Dr. Logan. At this point, we would like to take appreciation. We can possibly take from everybody. So we're going to ask one of the recipients of the award for tonight, Dr. Ike, to kindly come up. And on behalf of all the recipients of tonight's awards, he will give us a 40-second speech. Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. I think can we give a round of applause to the MC and all the people? Thank you very much. Good, our time is far spent. Your Excellency, Ambassador Ryan, ladies and gentlemen, I think it's an incredible honor first to be inducted into the Club of Distinguished Conquerors this night, and more so to present this response on behalf of the recipients. Personally, I think it's quite a honor to be a part of this distinguished group of people who have accomplished a lot. On behalf of the entire team, we'd like to say a big thank you to the leadership of the Old Boys Association for finding us worthy of this award today. Thank you all so much. And thank you all, too, for your attendance today and your patience. It's been a long night. But we really sincerely appreciate your honoring us all, and we thank you so much for this. I'm sure I speak on behalf of all of us when I say that we're not going to take this conferment lightly. I've seen a couple of young Fimbarians outside, and I'm particularly impressed at the conduct of the students, which sort of tells us that the legacy Father Slattery left continues to linger on many, many, many generations after that. And now that we've been inducted, I'd like to say that we will also contribute actively to extending that legacy proactively and actively when called upon to do so. So on behalf of the entire group of inductees this night, I say a big thank you to you all and a big thank you to the Old Boys Association for the opportunity. Thank you and good night.
I could hug you, you know. I could hug you. That was a beautiful speech. Thank you and well done. he's done so well, Dr. Ike. May I ask for another round of applause for that gentleman? Such a gentleman. So, I'm told that the ICT gang of the Old Boys Association got angry recently, and they decided that we should have a proper school website. And so tonight, we're going to take the opportunity of having them all in here to launch our St. Finbar's College Old Boys Association website.
So we'll do that for just 2 minutes. Just put it up. Let's see what it looks like. And we will ask you to kindly go to the website, take the details, go to the website and see what is in there. It will tell you a lot about the St. Fimbres College Old Boys Association and what it does. Do we have it up? Do we have it up? A quick reminder that the buffet is still open. For those of you who can still eat late at night, I can't. Beyond 7:30, I don't do anything. Do we have it up? If it's not up, let's go on to the next. Presido, is it coming? Okay. So we'll crave your indulgence just for a couple of minutes. Let's look at the Old Boys Association website. Yeah? No? Okay. Well, this will only get our ICT people angrier, even angrier. They would have expected it to be flying like no man's business. So I guess that they will look into it. And I'm just waiting for the permission of the committee members that we move on to the next thing. Usually, as a public speaker, when you get stuck like this, you tell one story or the other. But as I am now, I have a serious complex. All those citations have given me a complex. Let's call it flush. My flush black suit is turning green with envy. So envious of all these boys. And you know, they were tricking us all the while. People like John Weiss, especially. Johnny will go out with us. We will rock all the girls. Sorry, we will go out, play around. But when he gets home, the guy, they read. Me, I'll just carry my school bag. Homework, I don't go do. Just throw it in one corner. Go to the... When the school start results came out, some of us had to send our family to go and check it on our behalf. Is it up now? Is it? Should have invited him, asked you to clap for him. Okay, so clap for him so that he can now present to us the Old Boys Association website.
Thank you very much. For want of time, I'd like to stand on the existing protocol. Okay. His Excellencies, distinguished guests, fellow alumni and treasured friends of St. Fimbres College, Akoka, good evening. I am delighted to welcome you to this historic occasion of the launching of SF Scoba alumni website, which is the result of the vision, dedication, and hard work of many people. The website has a user-friendly interface that allows easy navigation and access to information. These are some of the features or the information you'll find on the website. It provides up-to-date information about the father, his very Reverend Father Dennis J. Slattery, from his peregrination to Nigeria to the founding of our great alma mater, St. Fimbres College. It also provides historical information about our school and its achievements in the fields of sports, academics, legal, media, IT, engineer, and job-creating entrepreneurs, helping to build the nation's economy, just to mention a few, and as you have all collaborated in tonight's event. It also provides updated information about the national executive members and their profiles. It contains a gallery and events pages that updates you with the latest information on events as they take place. You will also be finding this event soon uploaded on the website. The website is also linked to all of our social media handles from Facebook, LinkedIn, and our YouTube channel. We employ you to visit and connect with us via these handles, as all channels are active with interesting and socially interactive content. In addition, the website comes integrated with an authenticated and authorized members-only community portal that allows members to socialize with one another. You don't need to search for your old friends, as the system or the portal automatically brings you together with members of your set. It allows you to join social groups or to even create one to bring together great minds to deliberate on common interests. Free and fair elections can now be conducted via our community portal, and results dynamically collated and displayed instantly at the close of the election without users' input. However, take note, all members will be able to view and print results, but only premium members will be allowed to vote by the system automatically, and many other features. Also, we accept and treasure members' feedback via the feedback menu for members only. This is a valuable tool because it helps us to provide you with the best, no, I mean better user experience. So take note, this initiative is a scalable platform that meets our growing need at SF Scuba, and hence, we are already planning and working on the next phase that will include features like the SF Scuba Media platform, which will allow election candidates to run their campaign. We'll also be having the SF Scuba Bulletin Board, where we will be posting interesting and informative articles for members' research, and also, you know, for the benefit of readers' delight. And also coming up will be the marketplace, which will be the very first stop for alumni to find service professionals soon. So I can go on and on, but I want, because of time, I want to apply every one of us to please visit the website, sfscoba.net, www.sfscoba.net, and register as a member. I hope you will enjoy exploring and using the SF Scuba alumni website, and I also look forward to seeing you online. Thank you very much for your attention. Boys.
We asked him to talk around the school Old Boys Association website, and he gave us a political, campaign. Anyway, let's give him a round of applause for that. So it looks like we are drawing very close to the end of the program. We would like at this point to call a gentleman who has sat right there looking at me with some whatever it is in his eyes. I say, if this guy was in school with me today, I would have dealt with him. He is the school administrator, current, thank God, the current school administrator, St. Fimbres College, Akoka. He will be giving us the vote of thanks. So I want you all to please help me as we welcome Reverend Father Emmanuel Babalola for the vote of thanks.
Distinguished guests, on behalf of St. Fimbres College and the organizing committee of 2023 Father Slattery Memorial Lecture. I want to thank the Almighty God for the gift of today, for the gift of Father Slattery to us, for the gift of bringing all of us here together, and for the success of this event. May his name be praised now and forevermore. We thank, in a very special way, His Grace, the Archbishop of the Metropolitan See of Lagos, Alfred Aliwale Martins, represented by Very Reverend Father Francis Ike, the Parish Priest of Church of Assumption, Falomo. We thank His Grace for his care and fatherly support for St. Finbar's College. May God continue to bless him and keep him through Christ our Lord. Amen. We also want to thank in a very special way His Excellency, Mr. Peter Ryan, the Irish Ambassador to Nigeria, for his keynote address. May God bless you, sir, and continue to keep you through Christ. Who work log and to make a log and to make a positive impact in our respective fields. Guide us in our pursuit of wisdom and understanding. And as we depart from this place, may the good Lord lead us safely to our various destinations through Christ our Lord. Thank you.
Holy Queen, we bend before thee, Queen of purity divine. Make us, Lord, we do implore thee, make us truly to be. Teach us, Holy Mother, how to conquer every sin, how to love and help each other as the prize of life to win. Thank you. Do have a nice evening.